adopted. Now calling attention, Shetty Arvalu.
Madam, I call the attention of the Minister of Agriculture to the following matter of urgent public importance and request that he may make a statement thereon pertaining to regarding plight of coconut growers of Tamil Nadu leading to starvation deaths and steps taken by the government in this regard.
Honorable Minister.
अध्यक्ष महोदय, तमिलनाडु के नारियल उत्पादकों की दशा के संबंध में माननीय सदस्य द्वारा व्यक्त चिंता से मैं पूरी तरीके से
अवगत हूं। बालू जी, हैव यू रिसीव्ड द स्टेटमेंट? सो ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर, यू कैन
लीड
द टेबल ऑफ द हाउस। यस श्री बालू।
मैडम, आई वुड लाइक टू ड्रॉ द काइंड अटेंशन ऑफ द ऑगस्ट हाउस थ्रू यू about the plight of the coconut growers in the state of Tamil Nadu, especially in the districts of Tanjavur, Tiruvarur, Dindukal, Theni, Tirunelveli, Coimbatore, Tirupur, Kanyakumari, Krishnagiri, Salem, Madurai, Erode, Pudukottai and Nagapattinam. Madam, 6 months back, some of my friends, particularly the former ministers, Mr. Kannappan, Mr. I. Periswamy, Mr. Alagu Thirunavukarasu, and Pongalur Panichami, and Kambam Ramakrishnan MLA, and other stakeholders who met me, and they expressed the problem faced by the coconut growers of Tamil Nadu, leading to suicidal death also. Subsequently, on 11/7/2012, I met the Honorable Minister for Agriculture, the Sarath Bawarji, and explained the various problems faced by the Tamil Nadu coconut growers. This matter has also been discussed in the UPA meeting, wherein Madam Sonia Ji and the Prime Minister and Sarath Pawar Ji were present. And finally, the Honorable Minister for Agriculture, Mr. Sarath Pawar, came to Tamil Nadu. He met the stakeholders, the members of parliament, MLAs, various public representatives, and the office bearers of more than 23 Coconut Growers Association, madam. The meeting was attended by so many most important coconut growers in the state of Tamil Nadu, and more than 3.5 hours, a lot of interaction went on between these coconut growers and the minister. In fact, I take this opportunity to thank my friend Mr. Sarath Pawar Ji. Madam, the total area of the coconut cultivable land available in the state of Tamil Nadu is 3.9 lakh hectares. And Tamil Nadu is it stands first as far as the productivity is concerned. 14,000 nuts per hectare per year is the productivity of coconuts in particular state. The state stands first, and this is the largest state of Tamil Nadu is the largest coconut producer of this nation. Madam, more than 10 lakhs farmers and 1 lakh, nearly about 1 crore laborers are involved in the particular profession. At least 53 executive pieces and 43 indigenous varieties of coconuts are being maintained by 2 research stations. One at Vepangulam of my district, Tanjavur district, and next one is at Aliyar Nagar in Coimbatore district. But neither the research centers nor the scientists of this country could detect or invent any medicine for the microbial disease, madam. For the past so many years, more than 5-6 years, to my knowledge, more than 6 years, the particular microbial disease is prevailing throughout Tamil Nadu. That is why the yield is reduced. The coconut is not yielding properly. In spite of it, Tamil Nadu stands first as far as the productivity is concerned. Madam, to be very frank with you, I could point out a particular Deputy Director General, Mr. H.P. Singh, the Deputy Director General of Horticulture, ICAR, who attended the 21st All India Coordinated Research Project and POMS, AICRPP, said, the disease won't never, they said, the disease prevailing never end. He further states, I quote from Times of India on 12/7/2012, he said, I quote, we have noticed yellowing, a serious disease seen in coconut and palm trees in Tamil Nadu. We don't have complete cure for the bacterial infection. It is global, unlike cancer, unquote. This is what the person who is in charge of horticulture has said, madam. Hence, farmers are just blinking. They don't know how to carry out the profession. They are the scientist or the government of India has not so far identified the curative medicines. There are no medicine for this particular disease. We don't have any water because of drainage fail. Even the subsoil water could not be bailed out because of there is no current at all, there is no power at all. More than 17 hours there is no power for farmers. There are a lot of problems undergone by the farmers, madam, because of the water scarcity, because of non-available pesticides, because of the high price for the pesticides as well as fertilizer. The farmers are suffering a lot. Tamil Nadu is a water-starved state. You know pretty well. Neither Mullai Periyar nor Kaveri flows in the particular state as a matter of right. We have to get water from both Mullai Periyar Dam as well as from Krishnaraja Sagar. We are not getting water because of various issues. Best note to my friends of the particular states. So there is no water, no rain, no power, no pesticides. Prices of pesticide and fertilizer going in rocket speed. We are not getting proper facility, neither from the nature nor from the government of India, madam. Madam, I would point out, over and above this natural disaster, the problems, government of India policies is not helping the farmers, madam. Firstly, government of India has permitted crude palm oil at 0% duty. Over and above, they are extending subsidy. What I suggest is, instead of giving subsidy to the crude palm oil, the same subsidy can be extended to coconut oil, madam. It can be distributed through PDS with the help of the state governments. This government of India should come forward to see the same subsidy extended to crude oil, crude palm oil, can be extended to the coconut oil, which is also EDB oil, through PDS, madam. Madam, what is happening in palm oil import, madam? In 2011-12, November 2011 to May 2012, the quantity of import of palm oil is 10,84,033 tons. 10 lakhs and above. Whereas the same period, November 2010 to 2011, it was only 5,51,327 tons only. How come, madam, 97% over and above the consumers consume? And not only this, more than 82% of palm kernel oil has been used in a particular time. How come palm kernel oil of 82% over and above the previous year and 97% of the palm oil over and above the previous year could be consumed by Indians, madam? I think the government of India should come forward. What is going on in the import of crude oil, palm oil and kernel palm oil? Secondly, madam, Government of India is permitting coconut cake, oil cake, madam, from Philippines and Sri Lanka. What is happening? The oil cake, so-called oil cake, is not de-oiled oil cake. They just bring the oil cake to feed cattle. To feed cattle at 0%, they are importing the oil cake. But whereas the oil cake is not fully extracted. Say they bring the oil cake here, they extract the oil, coconut oil, and sell it to the Indians at a cheaper price. Wherein our people could not compete with those people. That is why the price, the product of the coconut products as well as coconut nuts could not be sold in the market for the proper price. Madam, thirdly, madam, the MSP has been fixed at 41 rupees per kilo for the coconut. With 51 rupees. This 51 rupees is not at all sufficient comparing to all, because the past year time I could not spell everything, because a lot of two or three pages I have to read for the input, pesticides and everything, fertilizers and everything. 51 rupees is very, very meager amount, madam. When I met the minister, he was only cursing. I don't know how to tackle this issue. That is what he has told. But my problem is, the problems of the coconut growers is very much important. It has to be addressed very quickly and speedily, madam. See, unless otherwise the government of India comes forward to extend 74 rupees per kilo, these problems the farmers have to resort to suicidal death only, madam. Not only that, madam. Those who are producing copra, they have got the infrastructure. But at the same time, the people who are not having the infrastructure, they are miserably failing. They could not sell the copra. See, Government of India has identified the MSP only for copra, not for dehusked coconuts, not for dehusked coconut. They fixed the price only for copra. Where should be the ordinary people, ordinary farmer who is having 1 acre, half an acre, 2 acre land? Where will he go? Where is the chance for him to invest? He's already burned his fingers. The government of India should apply their mind properly, man. They are hesitant to apply their mind. There is a board, Coconut Development Board. But Coconut Development Board is doing nothing. They could not deliver the goods properly. The problem of this coconut growers persists forever. And they are almost treated as untouchables. So Government of India should come forward to see that this particular issue is addressed very much properly. And see, madam, what the Government of India, the agriculture minister on the other day, he was telling to me is, where is a chance for me to store this coconut when I purchase from the market through NAFED or something? इज परचेसिंग पेडी इज परचेसिंग वीट इज स्टोरिंग एवरीवेयर बट आई कुड नॉट परचेस कोकोनट व्हाट इट मींस मैडम आई डोंट नो हाउ दे सेड दैट देयर इज नो स्पेस वी डोंट माइंड अबाउट स्पेस और एनीथिंग वी वांट द थिंग्स टू बी एड्रेस्ड प्रॉपरली otherwise coconut growers will have to shift their cultivation and they have to import from Sri Lanka they have to import from the Philippines only so this matter has to be addressed very properly and on the other day minister has said that we will open procurement centers from 17 to 34 he has not done so far he has said he will increase the appointment of field officers as much as possible maybe he will be he would have written to honorable finance minister I don't know what has happened or the GAS also said I will order for 24 hours payment so far nothing has happened and the MSP price MSP of 51 rupees should be increased to 75 rupees that is not had happened minister has not promised the entire set of people who attended the particular meeting more than 400 people vociferously they appealed the minister I can only request my friend to see that this should happen as quick as possible otherwise Gamanda will be a party to see some burial grounds in Tamil Nadu thank you very much